So the telomerase enzyme is a very interesting enzyme that is intracellular, that is has the ability to actually rebuild telomeres by adding back base pairs. So it's a RNA reverse transcriptase. And this was discovered by Liz Blackburn and Carol Greider and colleagues over 25 years ago. And they were showing how if you knock it down, the cells cannot divide anymore. And if you upregulate it, the cells become immortal. So it is an important regulator of how long a cell can divide. It's one of the major determinants of telomere length, because if your telomeres shorten and you have a lot of telomerase, you can repair them, you maybe even can lengthen them.
And telomerase, if I remember correctly, it's more active in stem cells than in somatic cells for
right.
the most part?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so at UCSF, my colleague Julin actually has an assay that's very sensitive and can measure the level of telomerase in our normal blood cells. They're not cancerous, they're not stem cells, but you can still measure the level. And that is associated with health, with metabolic health, with socioeconomic circumstances. So
interesting. Mm-hmm. So you mentioned this sort of potentially double-edged sword with, in terms of, you know, the telomeres getting critically short and telomerase activity going down, and that leading to cellular senescence. We've had Dr. Judy Campisi on the podcast. We've talked a lot about senescence.
Yes.
But or even apoptosis, or you said they can become immortal when mm-hmm. telomerase becomes overactive, and that, you know, so basically it's just constantly rebuilding the telomeres, and immortality in some cases with the overactive telomerase is associated with certain types of cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So what would you say, like, you know, measuring, you're just talking about measuring telomerase activity in white blood cells, and that's sort of a marker for, you know, the aging problem, how well a person's aging or how well the cells are aging.
Mm-hmm.
Is there a threshold for when it becomes too active and it's like a cancer cell? Like, can you detect that difference? Like, is it when it's like always active?
Well, so in our research, we always make we're not measuring any cancer cells. Otherwise, I mean, they're tenfold higher in telomerase, so
tenfold.
It would mess up our measures.
Okay.
Yeah. So it becomes in cancer cells.
It's kind
becomes,
of what I was asking. Like,
yeah,
what degree?
It becomes like out of the physiological normal range. So,
okay.
Yeah. So it is true that that tumors develop a mechanism so that the telomerase is so high and they kind of immortalize themselves in that way. So the telomeres can be really short, and maybe that's how there was a mutation in the first place, but the telomerase is very protective, so it gets
right.
very high. Yeah, so, you know, this is a telomeric aging is complex. It's not just longer is better. In general, longer is better. And long telomeres genetically or measured in the blood predict less heart disease, less mm-hmm. metabolic disease. But actually, longer telomeres, especially when you measure the genetic index, but sometimes also when you measure it in the blood, long telomeres also predict greater risk of certain cancers, mm-hmm. like glioma and melanoma and several others. So it is, you know, it's homeostasis, it's physiology. You want to be long, but not extremely long, if you want to kind of have right. the best ratio of low risk for degenerative diseases like dementia and heart disease, and low risk for cancer.